Square Garden lit up for the holidays, getting set for the Rangers and Colorado Avalanche. They'll meet next week, Tuesday, in Denver as they play their two-game series. Check out our Audi goaltending matchup, and there is 6'4", 24-year-old Adam Huska. And you see his numbers this season, goals against average, save percentage, quite good in Hartford. Had a good season last year with the Hartford Wolfpack, 9-4. Darcy Kuemper back from injury. The leader, the number one goaltender for the Avalanche, 9-5 on the season. Started his career with Minnesota.
Now Mika Zibanejad, Gerard Gallant told us before the game he's really happy with his two-way game. He says, yeah, I'd like to see him score a few more goals. So would he, but he likes the two-way game, and so he is starting this game against that top center that we talked about.
Nathan MacKinnon was the number one pick overall in the 2013 draft. And he is one heck of a player. Fox sends it in. Rangers with Zibanejad, Kreider, and Kako. Lindgren and Fox on defense. Logan O'Connor, number 25 for Colorado. Their captain, Gabriel Landeskog, number 92, on a big, strong forward. This is Kreider. Now Kako toward the net. It's gloved by Kuemper, and he holds it. Kuemper with a 4-1 lifetime record against the Rangers.
And they're looking for him to be the number one guy after they made a big trade with Arizona to get him. They gave up a good young defense prospect and a number one draft pick to get Darcy Kuemper. And he's been in and out of the lineup. He just missed the five games. So as you mentioned, Sam, just back from that. This Colorado team, their record is almost identical to what it was at this point last year, which is very good. But they've given up a lot more goals than they did a year ago.
And last year they won the President's Trophy as the number one team in the regular season. They won their first round of the playoffs. They swept St. Louis, but then the Vegas Golden Knights got them in the second round.
Yeah, they led that series 2-0, and then Vegas wins 4 straight.
Trouba and Miller on defense. Poked loose. Trouba moves it up the board to Eric Johnson. That's a former number one pick overall as well. That shot toward the net was stopped, and the Rangers come back with it. Ryan Reeves dumps it in. Boy, this line had a good night in Chicago last night. Rooney with a goal. Goodrow with a goal. Reeves with 2 assists. And making the highlights all around with that between the legs pass, Joe.
It was beautiful, wasn't it?
That was special. Strom, Panarin, and Dryden Hunt have come on with Nemeth and Lundqvist on defense. Burakovsky, Andre Burakovsky with the puck, number 95. Long shot by Makar. And you mentioned that, Joe. He loves to shoot. He leads all defensemen in goals scored with 11. Cale Makar, number 8. Lundqvist bumped on the play. Alex Newhook, number 18, is on. And Darren Helm, number 43, longtime Detroit Red Wing,
right.
Played 744 games with the Red Wings. Now with Colorado.
Just a good, solid checking winger, penalty killers, always had good speed.
Avalanche coming off a wide open game in Philadelphia on Monday night, in which they beat the Flyers 7-5 and had 50 shots on goal. That shot went wide and goes all the way out and back into the Avalanche zone. Jack Johnson, who was with the Rangers last season, is healthy again. This is his 21st game of the season for Colorado.
Now, last year was like a write-off.
Oh, terrible for him. Got hurt early in the year, wound up having surgery.
Yep.
And
tried to come back and play with it, and it just didn't work.
A little over 3 minutes gone by here in the first period. Jacob Trouba firing it off the board, sent back deep by O'Connor, Logan O'Connor. Battle in the corner, Landeskog. Trouba trying to move it, blocked. Good forecheck pressure by Colorado here. O'Connor, the Rangers got the puck by him. Off the boards to Kreider. Stick save by Kuemper. Nice pass from Mika Zibanejad to Chris Kreider.
Now Gerard Gallant said, I expect a fast game, and he's getting it to start off.
Rangers take it. Quick transition. Zibanejad in deep. Had two assists in the game last night. Puck lifted out. Fox there to stop it. Zibanejad tried to move it. Nichushkin. Valeri Nichushkin, number 13. Started his career with Dallas. He was injured early in the season as well. He's getting his game back together. Kadri with a pass to Rantanen, who scores. Mikko Rantanen, the man we talked about right at the top, fires a low, hard shot past Adam Huska, and the Avalanche grab a 1-0 lead.
Yeah, that, just a fabulous wrist shot. And a turnover in the neutral zone, and they were able to gain the blue line with some speed. Might have used the defenseman as a screen on the play, which was Adam Fox. This will give us a little better view, and just past Fox, and just getting a piece of it was Huska off the blocker and in.
Rantanen has only scored in one of the last seven games coming into play tonight, but that one was a hat trick game, so he can go on these tears, and that was a beautiful shot. Rantanen in again. That's deflected by Nemeth up in the netting, and play stops. Nemeth in on defense with Niels Lundqvist. There's the head coach of the Rangers, Gerard Gallant. Said he's not worried about the players playing back-to-back games. No. He feels they'll be ready to go in this one. Newhook wins the faceoff for Colorado. McDonald's shot redirected, and a good save with a left pad.
Boy, was that ever, Sam. He was going to his right and had to stretch that left leg about as far as it could go to make the save.
Huska out to play the puck. Lundqvist moving it up the boards. And Rooney able to get it out of the zone. That was back just in offside Colorado.
That was just a play, just a clean faceoff win by Colorado. That, and you know, again, the quick shot through gets deflected, and Adam Huska, after allowing that goal, is so that's the next shot he faces. He makes a good save, and there's Jared Bednar, the head coach of the Colorado Avalanche. He just signed a 2-year extension.
Good for him.
Yeah, he's done a nice job.
Yes, he has. Send in Devon Taves, number 7, the former Islander, on the ice. Was injured early in the season. Scramble around the net. The backhander by McKinnon went wide. Avalanche controlling play here. Taves toward the net. A save by Huska. Again with a left pad. Landeskog played it toward the net. Trouba was able to break it up. Here's Kaapo Kakko. Stick handling in. Shot blocked and grabbed on a hop by Darcy Kemper. Mikko Rantanen got the goal. His 11th of the season. Nazem Kadri and Devon Taves the assist.
You know, Sam, here's Adam Fox. He's going to try and make a pass all the way up the ice. And you're going to see Devon Taves right at his own blue line. Right there, he steps in front of Hunt, takes the puck, and then quickly the other way. And look at the counterattack. Fox never gets back to the blue line, so he's caught in no man's land and just has to back up on the play as Colorado, off that turnover, boy, they counter as well as anybody in the league.
Eric Johnson, number 6, getting it ahead to Rantanen. Checked from behind by Gauthier. Good play. Played off the boards to Lafreniere. Into the corner, Philip Hedl. Hedl, Lafreniere, Gauthier in the line for the Rangers with Fox and Lindgren. In deep to Chushkin. And that's offside. Came out of the zone. Time to take a deeper look with this stat line brought to you by Infosys. New York Rangers with 17 wins in 24 games. That is the most wins through 24 games in franchise history. So Well, this has been quite a run for the Rangers. 17-4-3 in 24 games. And starting play tonight, 1 point out of first place in the Metro Division, with a couple of games in hand on the Washington Capitals. Burakovsky, stick handling in, blocked by Lundqvist. Back pass tipped ahead. Jacob McDonald, number 26, with a puck that's blocked by Nemeth. McDonald again. Picked up by Lundqvist. Strome sending it around the boards. Kept in by McDonald. Both sides of the ice. Darren Helm, number 43. Trying to put it in front. Taken away by Nemeth. Panarin on the move. Just off the bench. Reeves still on to the side of the net. Reeves, turnaround, hit the side of the net. Panarin outside. Dribble with a shot. He scores! Jacob Trouba with another one. He did it last night with that shot. And here he is again. And the game is tied 1-1.
Well, Artemi Panarin finds some space in the neutral zone and able to get the line. Now, keep an eye on 75, who has the puck. He throws it there, but again, watch where he goes, directly in front of the net. So when Trouba takes the shot, it goes right past. Both players coming in, and Darcy Kuemper had trouble picking it up, and the Rangers, and that great wrist shot, tie the game at one.
Ryan Reeves was on the ice. The rest of his line was not on. He was still on the ice, and he made a big play. Helped the goal happen. And Jacob Trouba continues to add off.
And he just threw a penalty. Ryan Reeves just threw a penalty.
Extra man on as Husker went to the bench. Six skaters on for the Rangers. The late penalty on Colorado. And now it's whistled down. A chirping call. 12:33 to go, first period. Jacob Trouba, first goal of the game for the Rangers to tie it. Kreider is the third Ranger to score 10 or more power play goals in the first 24 games of a season. Who are the other two? Tweet your answer to hashtag Cadillac Trivia.
So Ryan Reeves does the great work and gets an assist on the first goal. And then look at this move here as Devon Taves comes over, gets his stick into the skates, takes down Reeves. And so he draws the penalty, and the Rangers get the first power play of the game.
This Rangers power play brought to you by your Tri-State Volkswagen dealers. Rangers power play is going strong with power play goals in four straight games and six of their last seven. The power play has moved up to seventh in the league, Joe.
Now you keep producing like they're producing. You just keep moving up the ranks.
Colorado's penalty killing has struggled. They have given up power play goals in three straight games and seven of their last nine. Strome to Fox, back to Strome. Kreider, Zibanejad, and Panarin on as well. Pass through to Panarin. Try to get it to Kreider in front, who is broken up. And this is Tyson Jost. Jost finds Eric Johnson. Saved by Huska. Tough shot by Johnson. Short-handed.
Yeah, odd man rush. Panarin tried to get the puck to Fox and ended up turning it over, and that led to the odd man rush.
Colorado tied for the league lead with six shorthanded goals. Dangerous team.
Whoa.
And that pass taken away by Logan O'Connor. Trying to break toward the net. Kreider got back to break it up. Fox back for the puck. 50 seconds to go in the Rangers power play. Panarin. Kreider across the line, down to Panarin, centers for Zibanejad. That was sent away by Darren Helm.
Now you can just see what Colorado's doing. They've been watching a lot of videotape on Panarin. Likes to, on his backhand, likes to go to the middle of the ice. He's back to the point or to the slot. And three times now they've intercepted that pass.
Rangers' second power play unit. Eric Johnson with a hit on Filip Hedl. And the Avalanche clear all the way down. Huska plays it out. Played it well off the stick of Kapokako. Back in, Huska has it go off his stick. Joe Stafford, number 17 for Colorado. And that's it for the power play. Rangers didn't get anything going on the power play. No shots on goal. And the game remains tied, 1-1, coming down to the midway point. First period, off the boards, taken away by McKinnon. Nathan McKinnon got a shot off for the save by Huskin, cleared away. Alert play by Nils Lundqvist. Puck kept alive by Logan O'Connor. Played back by Nichushkin to Makar for a shot blocked by Hedl. Lundqvist moves it up the boards to Lafreniere. Now Hedl sends it in.
It's been a first 10 minutes for the Rangers, Sam, of just a lot of turnovers. A lot of flat passes, east-west passes that Colorado's picking off and going the other way.
Patrick Nemeth pressured by McKinnon. Rangers take over. DeAndre Miller, high cross-ice pass. McKinnon trying to take it away, lost his stick as he was tied up by Kevin Rooney. Landeskog with a shot that's kicked away by Huska. From the point, Rantanen, that's blocked in front. Nemeth has it. 9:20 to go, first period, tied 1-1. Trouba got his sixth, his fifth goal in the last eight games. Well, a good run. Padre got it back to McDonald. Panarin on him. Saved by Huska. The rebound. Huska got a save on Rantanen at the side of the net, but a penalty upcoming on the Rangers. A save on Makar, and Colorado will go on the power play. 8:57 to go in this first period. Tied 1-1. Huska with a good save on Nathan McKinnon. To go between the benches, presented by Spectrum Mobile, unlimited for only $29.99. Switch and save up to 60%. Visit SpectrumMobile.com. We visit with Captain Dave Maloney. Dave.
Thank you, Sam. A very interesting start here. You know, Colorado comes in, billed as an elite team in the league. And you know what, Joe and Sam, there's not a lot of time and space for this Ranger team. This is a big Colorado team that can flat out skate. Very important penalty kill here. Huska, to me, looks pretty good. Moved nicely left to right, covering a lot of the bottom part of the net. He may get tested here, though, fellas.
Yes. Colorado power play, one of the best in the league. Rantanen moving it to Makar. To Kadri, back to Makar. And scored seven power play goals in the last five games. And 17 in the last 12 games. Makar up top, a good block by Rooney, who chases after it, gets to it, moves down with Goodrow. Rooney to the net, save Kemper, and he covers. Nice play by Kevin Rooney.
Yeah, he got closed on in a hurry, Sam, and I think he got slashed on the play as well, and he didn't get much on the shot. Nathan McKinnon came back hard. There's McKinnon, who comes back hard, and so Rooney was able to get to his forehand, but wasn't able to get much on the shot. And so that two-on-one was closed in a hurry by the speed of Nathan McKinnon.
Zibanejad and Kreider come on with Nemeth and Trouba. The Rangers penalty killers. Rangers penalty killing has been perfect over the last six games. They have moved up to 10th in the league. So top 10 in both special teams units. Trouba moves it up the board. Zibanejad gets it out of the zone. Cale Makar has it for Colorado. Just under a minute to go on the power play. 7:50 to go, first period, tied 1-1. Excellent play by Goodrow. Breaks in with Rooney. 2-on-0. Saved by Kemper. Here's Goodrow shooting, hit the side of the net. Trouba in deep. The puck frozen by Kemper, a 2-on-0 chance for Rooney and Goodrow, and Kemper came up with a huge save.
Goodrow makes a beautiful defensive play by getting right on top of McKinnon, right there, and it steals the puck. This is just a gorgeous save. It was a hard pass, a quick release by Rooney on the play, and Darcy Kemper just outdid both of them with the save. Gorgeous save by Kemper to keep this a tie game.
Rangers have been outstanding on this penalty kill. Puck stays right in the corner in the Colorado zone. Three Avalanche players there, but a terrific effort by Barkley Goodrow. New hook sent it back to Taves. And a nice move by Burakovsky as he moves in and shoots high off the glass. Big rebound, hit the top of the net and almost bounced in front. Along the boards, Girard, number 49. This is Devon Taves. Now Girard, pass through. Burakovsky, saved by Huska, and it's cleared.
Well, that's a good aggressive save by Huska. He was back in his net. When the pass came across, he kind of took two hard steps out to cut down the angle and make the save.
Two teams remain even, 1-1. Each team 0-for-1 on the power play now. Teams at full strength on the ice, Miller and Trouba. 6.5 minutes to go. First period tied 1-1. Kreider. Panarin got it to Miller. Here's Trouba with a wrist shot just wide. Big rebound. Darren Helm there to play it. Around the boards for Tyson Jost. Trouba pinched in. Burakovsky was stopped by Zibanejad. Hooked ahead. Trouba with a good hit. Behind the net. DeAndre Miller involved. Here's Eric Johnson moving it across to Jack Johnson. No relation. Chipped off the boards. Panarin fires it out to Kreider. Circling back, Eric Johnson. Now Jack Johnson. Rangers have Lafreniere and Gauthier on. This is Logan O'Connor. Checked by Nemeth. Gets it to Makar, the pass behind McKinnon. And Hedl able to move it across to Adam Fox. Rangers move up with it. Gauthier. Gauthier turns, gets it back outside to Nemeth. Now Lundqvist toward the net, blocked in front by Taves. Here's Nemeth. Around the boards, Taves steps in. Taves has played very well since coming back from injury.
Yeah, he missed the first 9 or 10 games of this season.
Here's Hedl trying to get to the net. That pass intended for Gauthier went by him. Lindgren, long shot blocked in front by Makar. Another shot deflected away. Taves gets to it. Good shift by the Rangers, but the shots were blocked. 4:45 to go in this first period. Lindgren goes deep with it. Falls down. Keeps it alive. And it's chased down by Nazem Kadri. Picked up by Nichushkin. Valeri Nichushkin with a shot stopped by Huska. Lindgren and Nichushkin in the corner. The back pass to Girard. Sam Girard checked along the boards there by Rooney. And Adam Fox finds Barkley Goodrow. Goodrow in against McDonald. McDonald stays with him. They continue to battle. Rooney comes off the boards with a shot. The save by Kemper, and he holds it. With 4:01 to go in the first period, Rangers and Avalanche tied 1-1.
What about Panarin and Reeves up front doing a little mixing and matching, right? Yeah, it starts with Panarin, left side of your screen. Panarin throws the puck behind the net. Reeves goes and gets it, tries to wrap it around. That didn't work, but Panarin picked it up. And what he does, he makes that 61-foot pass to the point with Reeves in front providing the screen, and Trouba puts it in with the wrist shot.
Jacob Trouba, you saw the numbers. He's got goals in back-to-back games. Reeves, who had 2 assists last night, picks up another assist. Trouba with 5 goals in the last 8 games. Panarin with a 3-game point scoring streak. But over the last 8 games, Joe, Panarin has 15 points. Almost 2 points a game. And he has moved up to a tie for 5th in the league in scoring.
Now he's just on fire, Sam, with the way he's playing. Everything he's doing.
Burakovsky's shot was stopped by Huska.
Now he's got that combination now, which he didn't have earlier in the season, of shooting at the right time and passing at the right time. Both are working.
Girard winds it deep for Burakovsky. One time Washington Capitals stopped. Rangers come out with it. sent in by Dryden Hunt. Rangers have Strome, Hunt, and Panarin on. Strome on Eric Johnson. Girard played it off the glass, and the Avalanche come out. Burakovsky. Pass ahead. Ooh, that was close to being an offside shot. By Jost, we stopped by Huska. And a good hit in the corner by Trouba forced the turnover, and the Rangers out with it. Off the corner boards, Sabanajan, save made by Kemper, and a penalty call. A holding call. What an effort by Sabanajan.
That was a perfect dump in of the puck. Hit the corner perfectly to deflect back to the front of the net where Sabanajan was going, and Jacob McDonald. Here's the dump in here, and McDonald, 26 in front, lets Sabanajan get behind him. And he has to hook him or hold him. And there you see the opportunity. Sabanajan still got a piece of it, but draws the penalty on the play.
Rangers' second power play of the game. This power play brought to you by your Tri-State Volkswagen dealers. McDonald for holding at 17-11. Rangers did not get a shot on goal on their first power play. Sabanajad, Strome, Kreider, Panarin, and Fox. On for the Rangers.
Avalanche penalty number 26.
Played back by Strome to Fox.
At 17-11.
Strome had it knocked away by Eric Johnson. Fox recovers. Logan O'Connor, number 25, on the forecheck for the Avalanche. Sabanajad up the middle, Panarin. Checked there by Devon Taves, and Darren Helm with a takeaway and a clear. 2:20 to go, first period. Here's Adam Fox. For Sabanajad, gains the zone. Nichushkin checking him. Jost comes back for it. Fires it around the boards. And it deflected out of play. Faceoff stays in the Colorado zone. 2:02 to go in this first period.
The Rangers are having trouble getting set up because of the pressure of Colorado. Even when they think they have some time, the forwards for Colorado killing the penalties, their back pressure is, you know, coming back and giving the Rangers some trouble. So the Rangers haven't been able to get set up either in that first power play they had nor in this one.
Second unit comes on. Hedl won the faceoff. Lundqvist with the puck. Lundqvist and Trouba. Hedl, Lafreniere, and Kako. Kako has the puck. Out to Trouba. Now Hedl to Lundqvist for the shot. He scores! Nils Lundqvist, first NHL goal! And it's a power play goal! And the Rangers lead it 2-1. How about that for the young man? Jim Ramsey,
left side of your screen is Lundqvist. Eventually he'll take the pass from Hedl. Hedl did a nice job stopping the pass from Trouba with his skate and then able to put it over to Lundqvist in a hard rising wrist shot. What a shot. And then that excitement. Trips himself on the way over. Congratulations.
Oh, that's great. Terrific goal for Nils Lundqvist, his first in the NHL. The Rangers lead. They've scored power play goals in five consecutive games. And in seven of their last eight, as the power play continues to be productive. That time they got to set up, Joe, and they won the faceoff. Hedl won the faceoff, and it led to the Rangers setting up and scoring.
They were forced to move the puck quickly because of the pressure, but they made good plays under pressure, in particular Hedl.
1 minute remaining in the period.
Nathan McKinnon outside. Taves with a shot. Huska with the save. So after giving up a goal, Adam Huska has made some good saves.
Yes, he has. He sure has.
And his first NHL goal. And the fans cheer the posting of Nils Lundqvist, first NHL goal.
The assist number 72.
Final minute of play, first period. Taves shot kicked away by Huska, played by Nichushkin. And the back pass out of the zone. Kemper passes it out, sent all the way back by Nazem Kadri. Goodrow on the forecheck. Lindgren goes to get it. Nichushkin on him. He's moved by Lindgren. Shot by Jack Johnson. A save by Huskin. He covers up. 9.4 seconds remaining in the period. Time to look at the amazing moment of the game presented by Lexus, the official luxury vehicle of the New York Rangers.
Yeah, what a feeling for the youngster. Here's the setup by Hedel. And Lundqvist just took one step over. Boy, what a wrist shot that was. And Kapokako says, I'm going to grab that. This is going to go on the wall someplace. Gives it to Jim Ramsey. And huge goal for the Rangers late in the period as they'll go to the second period with the lead.
Lundqvist in his 20th NHL game gets his first NHL goal. What a moment. A power play goal for the second unit. The Rangers come back with two straight goals after Adam Huska gave up one goal, but Huska settled down and the Rangers lead 2-1.
Yeah, he sure did. I think the one adjustment the Rangers are going to have to make in that second period is they gave up their blue line the entire first period. Colorado just kept skating over the blue line with the puck. Rangers are going to have to tighten up and try and break up more plays at their own blue line in the second.
Rangers head for the locker room with a 2-1 lead. Coming up, it's the first period intermission report brought to you by your local Honda dealers. Michelle Gingras will join us. Kevin Rooney will be here as special interview guest. Kevin Marr has the MSG 150. And then John Gianone, Steve Valiquette, and Henrik Lundqvist. We'll take a look at that first period and break it down with highlights and analysis. Rangers lead the Avalanche 2-1 end of one. Rangers and Avalanche heading for the second period here at Madison Square Garden. New York Rangers hockey on MSG Networks presented by Chase. Joe, what do you look for here in the second?
Well, Sam, I just think that the Rangers gave Colorado too much respect. I think they just gave them too much room. They let them handle the puck too much, carry the puck too much, over the blue line in particular. So, you know, the Rangers are better in the second half, and maybe that was just a, you know, getting your legs after going through what you went through last night. But I just think they need more puck pressure in this period, even though they're ahead.
Avalanche had 19 shots on goal in the first period. Adam Huska made 18 saves, makes another one there on a hard shot, a long distance shot by McKinnon. He was out near the blue line. Here's McKinnon again, keeping it in. Fox and Lindgren on defense with Zibanejad, Kreider, and Kako up front for the Rangers. Lindgren looking around. Nichushkin on the forecheck for Colorado. Tapped ahead by Zibanejad. And the Avalanche have it back. Nichushkin. Nichushkin took a hit from Kreider. Played by Kadri. Kadri has a point. The game 32 points on the season. Fourth best in the league.
No, Sam, he got a lot more important ice time when Nathan McKinnon missed the time with COVID and then missed the games with an injury. And Kadri took advantage of that. Boy, what a season he's having.
Yes. Rantanen's shot was deflected wide. Lindgren after Nichushkin plays it back, but out of the zone. Thus far, all the play in the Ranger zone. Eric Johnson swings it around to Sam Girard. The outlet to Burakovsky. Andre Burakovsky moves in and shoots off the glove of Huska.
Yeah, there it is again. They're just walking over the blue line and they're just skating into positions to get shots.
And good shot.
The Rangers got it. They got to tighten up, put a little more pressure on.
Rooney playing it ahead for Reeves. Avalanche break it up. Cleared out by Jack Johnson. A lead for Don Helm. Nice play by Trouba. And the puck out of the zone. Trouba off to a great start in this game. A goal and assist. Three block shots. Miller is going back. Trouba takes it. Long pass ahead. off the stick of Dryden Hunt, played by Devon Taves. Up the boards. Rangers able to keep in. Open man. Lundqvist shoots. Save. The puck loose. The rebound. Hunt had a chance, but it was blocked away. Long shot by Strome deflects wide.
Well, he ever, Sam. He was able to pull the puck out of the maze. I'm not sure if the defenseman got the block or if Kemper was able to get a piece of it.
Sent in on Kemper. Steers it away. Almost gave it away to Hunt. Out with the puck. Gabriel Landeskog. McCarr with the feed in the middle. It's off the skate of MacKinnon. In deep O'Connor. Now Landeskog up the boards, and Hunt tried to drive it out. It's picked up by Strome. Strome and Panarin move in. Panarin cuts to the middle. Got a shot off, but he was checked by two players, and Kemper stops it and holds it.
Now the Rangers had a pretty good chance just prior to that. They do a good job keeping the play in, and then here's Lundqvist with the shot. Boy, that was Kemper. He did get a right pad on Hunt, who was able to pull it out of there. Watch. Hunt is there. 29. He'll pull a puck away and then get a shot. And Kemper was there to clean it up.
Darcy Kemper. Back in the lineup after missing several games. And the Avalanche using some young goaltenders in their recent games, but this has been a good run for the Avs after a slow start to the season. Lindgren with a good hit on Kadri. Beadle had it taken away by Rantanen, but his pass blocked away by Lafreniere. He tried to lead Gauthier. Rantanen back for it. Rantanen has the Colorado goal. Rangers a 2-1 lead. Good hit down the ice by Lafreniere on Girard. Back for it, Trouba. A little over 4 minutes gone by here in the second period. Rangers have a 2-1 lead. Tipped ahead for Zibanejad. He shoots, close save, juggled and dropped by Kemper. Kako tried to play it. One shot by Trouba, saved by Kemper. Now it's the Rangers' turn to get some shots.
Yeah, Kemper really had to fight off that shot by Zibanejad, and then even the one by Trouba, he's leaving some rebounds.
Up for Kako. Zibanejad moves in. High with the shot. Well, he's shooting the puck more, which the coach talked to us about. He'd like to see all his players shoot more. But Mika's had trouble scoring goals. Here's MacKinnon. One-hander, poked it in. Nathan MacKinnon. It looked like he had lost control, but he poked it past Adam Huska to tie it in two.
It's a fabulous goal. I mean, it really is. Nathan MacKinnon shows the entire package on this. He shows his speed. He shows his strength. And he shows his overall ability. Here it comes. Gets right through one stick. Then beats Miller. Uses Miller. Is not in good position to play the man. Here it is again. Watch Miller just kind of bounce off him. And then just the reach right there. That's talent. To just reach out and give it a little poke. And surprised Huska on the play to tie the game at two.
Nathan MacKinnon missed 8 games. And since coming back, that's his first goal. But he has had points. He has 7 points in the last 4 games. And he's only had gone 1 game this season without scoring a point. His second goal of the season. And the Avs come back early in the second to tie it. Long pass ahead went by Ove Kubel. And it's an icing on the Avalanche. We're nearly 5 minutes into the second period. Rangers have Goodrow, Rooney, and Reeves on. With Lundqvist and Nemeth. Avalanche repositioning their defensemen. Tyson Jost in for the faceoff. Carr put it in the corner. Reeves goes to get it. Checked there by Jack Johnson. Reeves back pass to Nemeth. Lundqvist on the line. Long shot gloved by Kemper with Rooney in front.
Did you know you could bet on the 60-minute correct score of the game on FanDuel Sportsbook? Make every moment more and get in on the action now with FanDuel.
Darcy Kuemper thinking in deep thought.
Now the question is he, you know, is he the guy that can that can get him there? Because
well, Grubauer was there and then he left.
Well, he left as a free agent. Yeah. They couldn't come to a contract agreement. Became an unrestricted free agent and signed with Seattle. And so very quickly, Joe Sakic, the GM, had to make a deal, and he made one with Arizona to give up a good young defense prospect and a first-round pick for Darcy Kuemper. And so for Jared Bednar, he knows you don't get the goaltending, you don't win. It's that simple. So they're hoping that Kuemper can step in and get the job done.
Puck was deflected out of play.
It's one thing playing for an Arizona team that no one expects to make the playoffs, so then it's another thing going to a team and playing for them where everybody expects you to win a Stanley
Cup. That's it. You're right. A lot of pressure there. Icing whistle against the Rangers. Rangers fans head to the Garden on Sunday, December 12th, when the Rangers take on the Nashville Predators. Get tickets at NewYorkRangers.com/TIX. MacKinnon got the goal from Landeskog and Girard at 4:48. Landeskog with a 9-game point scoring streak.
Yeah, we haven't even talked about him, right?
That's right.
Captain of their team. 8-game point streak coming in, and we're trying to fit him into the open. Right? Where do you put him?
He's, you know what? He's something special as well. 9 years he's been captain of the team, and he's not even 30 years old yet.
They got him signed before he would have become an unrestricted free agent last summer.
It's a big re-signing. Huska stops the puck behind the net, plays it. He likes to play the puck, handles it well. That pass deflected over the Rangers bench and up into the crowd. Play is kind of slowed down here. There have been a couple of icings and offside and puck deflecting out of play a couple of times.
Yeah, when it's not doing that, it's at breakneck speed.
Gord Dwyer has gone over to talk to Jared Bednar at the bench. I think it had to do with the line change. But they'll do it again. Kadri and Strom. Strom wins it back. Around the boards, Dryden Hunt had it tapped away. Played to open ice. Nichushkin has it. Panarin on him. Rantanen comes around the net. Girard for Nichushkin. Strom trying to check him. The backhander blocked. Lindgren came over. Now Makar with a wrist shot. They score! It was deflected in front. Might be Nazem Kadri.
Yeah, it is, Sam. Right, they just, the way they skate and handle the puck, and they've had the puck most of this period. All right, the puck's been theirs. They've had it all over the ice. And that one gets deflected, and not much Huska can do. And they just keep moving. It starts with Rantanen over the boards, goes the other side. Now, you can't, the Rangers, I think, have been guilty of stick checking in this game, and it just doesn't work. Kadri coming out of the corner, Makar with the shot. There's the beautiful redirection. And two quick ones by Colorado make it 3-2.
Avalanche turn the game around. Kuemper firing it around the boards, blocked by Trouba. Frenier sending it back, but it's taken away by Landeskog. Now some Kadri with a goal and an assist in the game. Miller moves it up to Gauthier out of the zone. Lafreniere after it. Taken away by Devon Taves. Logan O'Connor with it. Now MacKinnon dropped it off. That hit the post. The shot by Eric Johnson. Woo. Rang it off. A loud ring off the post by Johnson. That pass intercepted by Trouba. Had to wait for Lafreniere, who's going to the bench.
Yeah, Lafreniere was slow going off the bench. A turnover would have given Trouba a pretty good chance.
Kako in the corner. Double team got it back to Lundqvist for a shot. Save Kemper.
Nice shot. Good hard wrist shot through people.
Lundqvist getting some confidence. He's shooting the puck. Scored his first NHL goal. Nemeth able to move it ahead for Kreider. He's tied up. It's lifted out by Zibanejad. Burakovsky playing it back. It's Makar, and on him was Kreider. That pass blocked by Kako. Good play. Played back by Kreider. But out of the zone. Nemeth backed up. And now it's Lundqvist. Avalanche with a 3-2 lead. Goals by Nathan MacKinnon and Nazem Kadri. Ward moving it for Nicholas Aubé-Kubel. The Avs picked him up on waivers from the Flyers. About a month ago. Dan Helm, former Red Wing, checked there by Lindgren. Double teamed by Goodrow. Aubé-Kubel with a little pass. Long shot by Jack Johnson. Went wide, deflected wide. On the boards, Kadri. Out to Johnson. Kadri again for Aubé-Kubel. That deflects into the corner.
Avalanche goal.
And again, Avalanche in control of the puck. Now it's taken back. Rooney gets it ahead. Reeves after it. And a penalty called. It's going to be on Ryan Reeves.
Reach for the puck. They got the skates of Kadri.
Play stops. 9 minutes gone by exactly in the second period. Rangers trailing 3-2. Ryan Reeves gets a penalty here.
It was done throughout this game. I mean, look at how they find space, gain the blue line, and turn that into scoring chances. Again, throughout. It's their puck. And the Rangers just haven't been able to find a way to slow them down, stop them from carrying the puck over the blue line and turning that into something. Here it is again. This is the goal. Fabulous goal by Nathan MacKinnon, who just blew by everybody. Rangers defense didn't get much help from their forwards from behind. And you see those sticks kind of waving around. That's not going to do it against MacKinnon.
Dangerous moment here for the Avalanche power play. 0-for-1 in the game. Trouba with a good play to move it up to Rooney. Rooney with Goodrow. Goodrow for Rooney. Just missed. Boy, those two have really worked well together on the penalty kill. Now the Avalanche set up. Here's Rantanen moved it into the corner to Landeskog. Here's Rantanen again. Makar to Kadri. Out to Cale Makar. Set up for MacKinnon. Saved by Huska. That pass. That was a shot pass by Kadri, went all the way through and out of the zone. We down the midway point, second period, 3-2, Avalanche leading it. Minute 15 to go in the Colorado power play. Rantanen checked there, and the Rangers able to clear. Kemper stops it behind the net. First time in the last 7 games, the Rangers have given up more than 2 goals in a game. Been so good defensively and tightening up when they needed to. That pass by Burakovsky didn't connect. Cleared by Kreider.
Yeah, this was certainly going to be their challenge, because every game it seems like Colorado scores 5, 6, 7 goals. I mean, they're a scoring machine. They've had trouble keeping the puck out of their own net, but nobody scores like they do.
Burakovsky. For Girard, he's stopped by Fox. Help from Kako. Burakovsky gets the puck. That shot high. Big chance for Newhook. And it's Newhook with a shot. He scores. He got a second chance and cashed it in. The Avalanche score on the power play. They have scored 3 straight goals here in the second period and lead 4-2.
And you know what? Newhook, after he missed the first one, Sam, he moved to his left and he put himself in a shooting position. He was all set. Here's his first one. Now watch him move to his left, and right there, he got it. He'll get the pass, and he's all set to get it. Bang! Right over the shoulder. There's the play again. The Taves will go back low, and Newhook just ready. And he wasted no time. He's another one of these. You don't hear a lot about him, but boy, he's a talented young player.
20 years old, a first-round draft pick in 2019. Played a couple of seasons at Boston College. Kemper makes a save, 9:10 to go in the second period. The Avalanche with a 4-2 lead. Tonight, Ashlyn Harris, Allie Krieger on the left, Megan Rapinoe of the U.S. Women's National Soccer Team, Sue Berg, WNBA. Ashlyn and Allie are new members of the Gotham Football Club, Joe.
Good luck to them.
Absolutely.
Nice to see him here. Been a lot of excitement in this building this season, hasn't
yes,
there?
Yes, sir.
Everybody wants to come and see the Rangers. They put on quite the show here. They got some work to do in this one, though.
Yes, sir. Devon Taves around the net, up the boards for Landeskog. Sent in by the Avalanche captain, Andre Miller reverses to Trouba. Takeaway by McKinnon. He gets knocked down by Trouba. And McKinnon shaking up on the play.
Yeah, he gets
and Landeskog is challenging Trouba.
Yeah. Trouba wasted no time.
Those are two strong men.
Trouba nailed him all right.
Trouba's hit. This man is strong. We saw last night. The good news from last night was that Juju Arcara is out of the hospital and will be fully recovered.
That's just a solid body check. It's a clean hit. You see McKinnon looking down for the puck. By the time he looks up, there's Trouba. He just read it, drifted right into him. And again, everything is down. Look at his shoulder. Shoulder first. That's just a clean body check, and Landeskog comes right over to him. Said, fine. No problem. I can do that too.
Tough way to do your job.
He stands up for himself.
Yeah, there's no doubt about
that.
Well,
that's what's changed about the game.
McKinnon,
he was slow to get up.
Going to the locker room to be checked out. That may have been called down from the League Observer, but McKinnon heading off. The doctors will check him out. Landeskog and Trouba in their respective penalty boxes.
There it is again. You see Landeskog is looking down to the ice trying to get control of the puck. And Trouba just came up, turned a little sideways, led with his shoulder.
And the Rangers.
Trouba backs everything up. Everything he does, he backs up.
Rangers have ended up with a power play as Landeskog is the man who instigated. I don't know.
I think we should see more of that, because we're seeing too much where a good body check
is being challenged
yeah. by somebody, and it's a fair, clean hit, and they should start giving more instigators. If that's the way it's going to be, you're going to take good body checks out of the game. That's what's happening. We're not seeing as much of that. It's a good, clean body check. You shouldn't be penalized for doing that. Unless somebody wants to fight you, then give them the instigator and put the other team on the power play. I think that's the right call.
Avalanche penalty number 92, Gabriel Landeskog.
So the Rangers on their third power play of the game. They're 1-for-2. Kreider sends it in. Kreider's Zibanejad, Strom, Panarin, and Fox for the power play. The second power play unit scored the goal earlier in the game. Landeskog got 5 minutes for fighting and a 2 minute unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. Trouba 5 minutes for fighting. A takeaway by Helm. He's stopped by Kreider. And it's cleared by Logan O'Connor.
The Rangers, this first power play unit has really had a difficult time making a good pass. They're passing to their teammates while they're under pressure. No time to make a play, and Colorado's making the defensive play.
Good hustle by Hedl. Second unit has come on. Hedl and Kako. Fox is still on. Lafreniere is on. And Dryden Hunt is on. Hunt is in front of the net. Fox looking. Now Kako back to Fox with room. Moves down, pass across, and the shot missed the net. Lafreniere taking the shot. Kako moves in. Looks up. Niels Lundqvist, who has the Rangers power play goal, is on now. There's Kako. Pass through, taken off the boards by Lafreniere. Maintains possession, pass for Dryden Hunt. Jack Johnson got it to Girard, and it's cleared. And that will do it for the Rangers power play. Huska able to play it out to Dryden Hunt. Deflects over the net and off the glass. And it's ruled that it hit the netting. And that does it. Power play is over.
You know, Kev, with Chase Freedom Unlimited, we can cash back on all our holiday shopping, earn 3% of drugstores.
I'll be at checkout. You'll bring the card.
Wait, I'm paying again?
Earn big time with Chase Freedom Unlimited. How do you cash back? Chase, make more of what's yours.
Nazem Kadri with a goal and an assist. His goal from Makar and Nichushkin at 6-11 gave the Avalanche a 3-2 lead, and then Alex Newhook, from Girard and Taves at 10:42 made it a 4-2 game. Rangers unable to capitalize on the power play. 1-for-3 on the power play in the game. Around the boards, brought out by Mikko Rantanen. Rangers have Reeves on with Rooney and Goodrow. Miller is paired with Nemeth, with Truba in the penalty box. Kadri to Devon Taves. Taves with two assists in the game. His second season with Colorado. DeAndre Miller. Fired out by Nemeth. Tipped ahead into the Colorado zone. McDonald back for it. Now Girard. Sam Girard skates it up. Now Nicholas Obey-Kubel with a shot. A save. The rebound went wide by Nichushkin, who broke his stick on the shot.
Pretty good defensive play by Zibanejad coming back on Nichushkin as well.
Zibanejad saved by Kemper. Stepping up is Lindgren. And he's battling there with Newhook. Puck deflected out of play. And the linesmen step in between Lindgren and Newhook. 5:28 to go, second period. Big period for the Avalanche, three goals. Kit plans are now available. Plans include matchups that you don't want to miss. Select your plan at rangers.com/holiday.
Here's the attempted shot by Lindgren, and then his stick comes up on Newhook. They get engaged, and Lindgren gets a penalty for high sticking.
Third power play for the Avs. They're 1-for-2, scored on the last one. That man, Alex Newhook, scored the goal. Important penalty kill here for the Rangers. Avalanche control. Cale Makar with it. Rangers have Rooney and Goodrow with Fox and Keandre Miller. That shot saved by Huska on the shot by Rantanen. Rangers have two excellent penalty killers, excellent defensemen in the penalty box right now in Truba and Lindgren. Lindgren was upset with the call by the officials. Makar moves it down, then hit the post. Rantanen brings it off the post. Second one they've hit in this period. Mikko Rantanen, who leads the team with 6 power play goals. Rantanen winds up, big drive, stick save by Huska. Along the boards, Burakovsky gets it back from Kadri. Now some Kadri. Outside, Cale Makar with a wrist shot that went wide. Boy, gets a lot on the shot. He can really shoot it. McCarr moves it up to Rantanen. As far, they kept it in the zone. That pass deflects across. Played by Burakovsky. Nichushkin. Burakovsky. And McCarr moving, shooting wide. Rebound goes wide by Kadri. Burakovsky. Rangers deflect the pass, and it's swept out by Goodrow. Good effort to finally get it clear. Kemper plays it up to Nichushkin. Down the boards comes Jost. Can't get there. And the Rangers clear it out. Lundqvist is on with Nemeth. Kreider up the boards to Nemeth. Rangers play keep away, killing off the final seconds. And a good penalty kill. Rangers survived several seconds in their zone. One shot on goal by the Avs on that power play, plus one post. Rangers come out trailing 4-2. There is Tyson Jost. Nemeth back for it. On the forecheck, Logan O'Connor. Good breakout. Here's Panarin. Panarin moves in. Tried a shot, partially blocked by Jack Johnson. Eric Johnson moves it up the boards. Picked up by Kadri. And MacKinnon moves in. And shoots and scores! It's Logan O'Connor! Logan O'Connor rips a shot! Up high on Adam Huska, and it's 5-2 for Colorado.
What a move he put on Miller. Miller thought he was going to go to the outside, and O'Connor just pulled the puck right into his skates and just slid right past Miller. Here it comes again. Watch how he'll just slide right past him. Ooh. And then take the shot. What a move by O'Connor. And again, another play where Colorado, they're so good with the puck. They're able to carry the puck over the blue line, and then their skill takes over.
Gerard Gallant having words with Gord Dwyer, one of the referees. Dwyer and Wes McCauley are the referees tonight. All right, they're ready to resume play.
I think he's trying to fire up his team. He does that as well. You know, he gets going and he tries to fire up his team by, you know, doing something else instead of. Doesn't yell at players much. This has just been a dominating period by Colorado. And now a bad change by the Rangers.
And O'Connor gets to it and goes to the net and scores. Oh, wow. Five goals here in the second period. And Logan O'Connor with back-to-back goals. It's 6-2 Colorado.
Yeah, and the Rangers got caught on a change. Hunt makes a pass. There's nobody on defense. So you see the Rangers at their bench, and that just gives O'Connor all that time. He takes one step. Watch it just cut to his right and shoot it all in one motion just inside the post.
Two goals in 22 seconds for Logan O'Connor. And I had mentioned MacKinnon earlier. He's in the locker room being checked out by the medical staff. O'Connor taken over with two brilliant goals. And you can see how upset Gerard Gallant is.
You know what? That's what makes Wes McCauley the best referee in the league. He knows the tension, what's happened to Gerard Gallant's team here in the second period. And he goes over and he stands there and he lets him get everything out.
Avalanche with five goals here in the second period. And this has been, quite honestly, the worst period the Rangers have had this season.
Avalanche goal, fourth of the season, scored by number 25, Logan O'Connor, assisted by
McDonald. The pass that's out of the zone. Darren Helm back to pick it up. Taken away by Goodrow. Moves in and shoots, saved by Kemper. Pushed ahead by Burakovsky, taken back by Nemeth. And in comes Rantanen, but lost control as he was checked by Nils Lundqvist.
At 17:36, O'Connor is the year.
Checks Rantanen. Goodrow battling Burakovsky. Nemeth able to move it, played up the boards. Reeves had it knocked away. And Reeves able to take over and lift it out of the zone. A minute 25 to go here in the second period. Colorado Avalanche have broken the game open here. Leading 6-2. Moving in deep was Taves. The shot by Rantanen and a save by Huska. Dale McCaw. Boy, this team can shoot the puck. 50 shots on goal in Philadelphia. That one deflected on goal off a Rangers stick. And a save by Huska. Let's check in with Dave Maloney between the benches.
You know what, guys? In that last sequence prior to the sixth goal, McDermott went after Trouba in the middle of the ice, right? And in the meantime, Ryan Reeves is trying to get off the bench to get into play. Now, Trouba is out of play because McDermott is chasing him around the ice. The subsequent conversation, I think, between McCauley and Gallant had to do with the coach trying to see why there wasn't an extra, why there wasn't a penalty for McDermott going after Trouba. McCauley's response is, what do you want me to do? I gave you an extra two on the first fight. And that ended the discussion.
No. There's no way the Rangers want to lose Jacob Trouba for any more time. They're just defending himself. Fox with a shot, saved by Kemper. 35 seconds to go in the period. Kaapo Kakko battling Devon Taves. Kakko comes out with it. Fox, that's deflected on the way in. They back out to Fox for a shot, saved by Kemper. Kakko. Around the boards. Good effort by Zibanejad on Taves. Kakko out to Fox. Cross ice, Zibanejad tried a one-time it, but was backing up and lost his footing. Kakko centers off the skate of Fox, and that's it for the second period. And a nightmare of a second period for the Rangers. The Avalanche score 5 goals to turn a 2-1 Rangers lead into a 6-2 Colorado lead.
Yeah, Colorado had all the energy, Sam. I mean, they had the energy, they had the extra step in the period, and they control the puck. I mean, they've got such a fabulous offensive team that if you're not right on top of your game defensively to try and defend against them, then they can do things like this, and it goes right throughout their lineup. So you're right, dominating period for Colorado.
Coming up in the second period intermission report, Kevin Maher has the Audi MSG 150. Henrik Lundqvist, Steve Valiquette, and John Gianone will talk it over and analyze what happened to the Rangers in that second period. End of two, Avalanche lead the Rangers 6-2.
Thank you very much, Sam. I had an opportunity to speak to assistant coach Gord Murphy really about that second period. I first thought he had his Colorado turned it up a notch. We didn't match the pace, and as a result spent too much time in the defensive zone, got caught flat-footed at the blue line in a couple cases, turned pucks over, all the things that add up to a lot of goals for Colorado in the second period. In the meantime, moving forward, get back to the Rangers hockey, which has been get the puck, head north, get the puck deep, force the opposition to come longer up the ice than they want to. All in all, a learning period for a young Ranger team that's faced adversity for the first time in quite a while, fellas.
Now you're right about that, Dave. Rangers have given up 6 goals in a game twice this season before tonight's game. Once against Calgary, once against Edmonton. Nathan MacKinnon back after being checked out after taking that big hit from Jacob Trouba.
That's good news. I mean, you hate to see players, especially the top stars in the game, be hurt and out of the lineup. Now, the one thing to remember about this, and again, this has been a Ranger team that has just about faced every challenge that they've had. This one is obviously their biggest. And for Colorado, it hasn't been a team that's been able to keep the puck out of their net. Mm. They came in number one in scoring, but 27th in defense. So
Eric Johnson with the puck for the Avalanche. We've been on a good roll here. After a 2-4 start, and they were 4-5-1 in their first 10 games. And then they've gone on a run of 9-2-1 in the last 12 coming into play tonight.
Yeah, Jared Bednar's team has dealt with a number of different issues, including COVID and injuries to key players. And for a long stretch, using your third and fourth goaltenders in your organization. And, their number two or 1A is Franco, who's just right back playing in the minors now, but he's been out for a long time.
Yes. They used Eustace Annonen in Philadelphia right the other night.
Right. That would be number four. Who's a bright prospect, but not ready for prime time.
Miller moved it ahead. Reeves, Rooney, and Goodrow on. Rangers led 2-1 into the first period. Nils Lundqvist had scored his first NHL goal to give the Rangers the lead. Jacob Trouba had scored. And the Avalanche exploded in the second. Here's Nichushkin's shot, partially deflected by Trouba, and it goes up into the netting out of play. Stream the Rangers game on MSG Go for an enhanced viewing experience, including live stats and trivia where you can win prizes. Watch the Rangers on the go. MSG Go, presented by Lexus, is free to download. Rangers will be in Buffalo Friday night. Hope you'll join us then on MSG Plus. And then Sunday night, Rangers home against the Nashville Predators.
And then right back on the road.
They go to Colorado.
Colorado Tuesday night.
Arizona Wednesday.
Wednesday, right.
Played across by Nemeth to Lundqvist. Dryden Hunt. Strom, Panarin, and Hunt on. Out with the puck, Nicholas Aubé-Kubel. The former Flyer swings it around the boards. Avalanche were changing. And the puck lifted. Devon Taves moves it to Cale Makar. Nathan MacKinnon has a goal in the game. The game in Philadelphia Monday night, 15 players scored at least 1 point. And tonight, 11 players have at least a point through two periods. Lafreniere tried to get it to Gauthier, who was checked by Taves. Puck given away to Fox, down low for Hedl, and that was broken up by Taves in front. Gauthier to Hedl. Hedl checked by Makar. Makar went down, and a penalty upcoming. A tripping call against the Rangers in the offensive zone. Philip Hedl going off.
Yeah. Battling for the puck on the boards. And Hedl ends up with the tripping penalty. There's Hedl battling hard with Makar. Makar comes back. Gets the puck. Hedl must have got his stick right under the skates of Makar, who went down on the play. And face off back in the Rangers own.
You can see how Gerard Gallant feels about that call. Avalanche 1-for-3 on the power play in the game. Nazem Kadri got the power play goal. Rantanen, Kadri, and MacKinnon all have scored in the game. Logan O'Connor with 2 goals in the game. He had gone 10 games without a goal, and then MacKinnon went to the locker room to get checked out after that big hit, and O'Connor took over with back-to-back goals.
Boy, You know, you mentioned it, Sam, the number of players that scored the other night. I mean, there's a lot of offensive talent on this team, right through the lineup.
Oh, good play by Goodrow on Landeskog. Rantanen leaves it for Gabriel Landeskog. Now McKinnon. Checked there by Nemeth. Goodrow takes it and clears it. Hustling after it, Zibanejad. Makar pokes it into the corner and got it to Newhook, who's on. Newhook has a goal in the game for the Avalanche. Landeskog drops it back to Devon Taves. Lindgren back for it. Up the boards, McKinnon for Rantanen. Rantanen bumped off the puck by Lindgren. Newhook tried to move it, did. Here's McKinnon setting up Taves. Saved by Huska, and he holds it.
Rangers fans, this is my garden. Welcome home.
Adam Huska in his NHL debut. 24-year-old, born in Slovakia.
Hasn't gotten a lot of help, Sam, you know. He hasn't gotten a lot of help in the game. The Rangers just, they look like a fatigued team. And when you're a fatigued team and you don't have that extra step playing against one of the best teams in the game, it can get ugly. And for Huska, boy, oh boy, he faced a lot of tough, you know.
He hung in there in the
period. He's still hanging in there. You know, he's still hanging in there. Good for him. But it's just one of those nights.
Jost. Taken down, bumped on the play, penalty called, and a tripping call called by Gord Dwyer on Patrick Nemeth will give the Avalanche their fifth power play of the game.
There's Jost, and you see the right leg of Nemeth reaches out, sticks out the right leg, and takes down Jost.
Gallant looks on. The Avalanche 5 huddling up to discuss a play off the faceoff here. Landeskog on Nemeth for tripping at 5:03. Avs have an 11-second two-man advantage with Hedl still in the penalty box. Goodrow faceoff win. The clearing attempt deflected. Out of play, Trouba turned and fired, but it went off the stick of an Avalanche player and out of play. 8 seconds to go in this two-man advantage. Goodrow, Lindgren, and Trouba on for the Rangers. Avalanche control, McKinnon to Makar. Rantanen. Sets up McKinnon and hit the crossbar. What a shot. Here's a break for Hedl. Short-handed. And it went wide. May have been deflected by Makar. Makar came racing back as Hedl came out of the penalty box and had a breakaway chance after that shot that hit the crossbar.
Goodrow made a good play. Instead of just firing it down the ice, he put it off the boards and allowed Hedl to skate into it and have the chance.
Joe, what a shot by McKinnon. Oh, man, here's McKinnon again. Mikko Rantanen. Devon Taves plays it across to Landeskog. Rangers have Zibanejad and Kreider, Fox and Miller. Taves, quick pass by Rantanen missed and goes all the way back. 50 seconds to go in the Colorado power play. We are 6:15 into the third period, and the Avs with a 6-2 lead on the Rangers. Whoa, and that was Strome's stick that may have offset or upset Jost. He went down trying to get away. Newhook and Taves. Sam Girard moves deep with the puck. Outside Devon Taves, 20 seconds to go on the power play. Girard Trouba on him. Trouba and Lindgren paired here on the penalty kill. Little switch of pairs. That shot by Girard went wide, comes all the way out. That does it. Rangers kill it off. Colorado now 1-for-5 on the power play in the game. 7:10 gone by, third period. Rangers down 6-2. Reeves moves it ahead. Jack Johnson. Valeri Nichushkin. Good play on the takeaway by Keandre Miller. McDonald for Johnson. Off the stick, Huska plays the glass. And Reeves bangs it out. This may be an icing, and it is an icing on the Rangers.
Now the power play for Colorado, and then this chance. Right in front is Landeskog up high. That's the shot from McKinnon. That goes off the crossbar, and then there's the pass off the boards to allow Hedl. And McCarr comes back, makes a good play. I think McCarr got the stick just as Hedl was taking the shot and forced it wide.
Off the boards and all the way back comes Jacob McDonald. Jack Johnson with the outlet off the stick of Aubé Kubel. Panarin. Lundqvist sends it in. Nemeth plays it in. Rangers in Buffalo Friday night, home against Nashville Sunday night, and then a couple of games on the road at Denver and Phoenix. Colorado and Arizona. Huska dives on top and stops play, and then the Rangers come home to play the Vegas Golden Knights. Enjoy more of the Garden with Chase. Let's go to John Giannone and Steve Alekhed in our studio for more on tonight's game. Good size, 20 years old, and he's starting to play very well for the Hartford Wolfpack in the American Hockey League. Plus 10, 6 assists in the last 9 games.
I really like this kid. He had a very good training camp. Opened a lot of eyes. They kind of had a pretty good idea what they were getting when they drafted him. They moved up in the draft actually to be able to grab him at that spot. And so they really like the future of Braden Schneider.
A real good prospect. Take away by Landeskog. Checked by Trouba. Eric Johnson was pressured, but the puck kept in. Rantanen tried to get out in front. Panarin plays it back to Trouba. Trouba with a goal and an assist in the game. Panarin sets up, pass through for Dryden Hunt. Makes a move on Rantanen and a save by Kemper. Strong move to the net by Dryden Hunt. Back the other way, Sam Girard. Pass through to McKinnon. Watch out. Oh, Girard. Great play by Huska. Then Girard just dove into him. And now we've got everybody together. There's a penalty coming up on Girard. Somebody's helmet came flying off in that wrestling match. Trouba's involved. And it's at McDermott, who's been trying to challenge Trouba. He doesn't want to fight him. He doesn't want to fight McDermott. McDermott's been asking for it, and he goes to the penalty box.
Well, Girard will end up taking the pass from McKinnon. And Girard's a small, here he is here, and he just, you know, by the time he looked up, Huska came outside the blue paint really aggressively to cut down the angle, and for Girard, not much time to stop. Girard is not that type of player to be running over people. He doesn't play that way. But the Rangers, you know, you take exception when somebody runs into your goaltender.
And McDermott has been targeting Trouba.
Yeah, he's
been
going.
As soon as he goes right out and jumps Trouba right there.
New York penalty number 8, 2 minutes for roughing.
All right, Trouba's going to get two for roughing. McDermott's going to get 2 minutes for roughing and a 10-minute misconduct.
Yeah, he's out of the game.
So he is done. And Girard gets 2 minutes for goaltender interference. And the Rangers wind up with a power play. I believe they do. I think McDermott got two and ten.
That, I believe you're correct, Sam. He did get 2 and 10. And so the extra one goes to Girard. And so the Rangers on the power play.
Zibanejad wins it back. Rangers with a goal on the power play by Nils Lundqvist in the first period. They're 1 for 3 on the power play in the game. And the other two power plays, they didn't get a shot on goal. As Colorado's doing a good job, especially against the Rangers' first power play unit. And that's whistled out for an icing on the Rangers. They've been out of sync the whole game.
They have, Sam. Yeah, they have. And give credit to Colorado. I mean, I think it's a combination of things. The Rangers have looked a step off all game, and I don't think there's any question they're fatigued. It's not an excuse, it's a fact. And then Colorado, with the way they play, pressure, pressure, pressure. And so if you're just a little off and you got a team that's putting pressure on you, that's going to lead to mistakes, and that's the way the game has gone.
Helm won the faceoff. As I mentioned earlier, that, you know, Joe said the pressure attack. Here's a chance, short-handed. Big save by Huska on Darren Helm. Huska's without a stick. It's off to the side. Rangers move out, and Huska goes to get his stick. He made a great save. But Colorado looks for the shorthanded opportunities. They have 6 shorthanded goals this season. Tied for the league lead. Panarin to Fox.
2 minutes, goalkeeper.
Strome pass deflects to the corner. Panarin's got it. Now Fox. Panarin again. Pass through to Strome. Down low for Kreider. Just missed. Went by Kreider. Good idea. Just missed connecting. Fox to Panarin. Kreider's at the top of the crease. Pass deflects across. Strome has it. On him is O'Connor. Fox. Panarin. That's deflected by Eric Johnson. Strome to Fox. 20 seconds to go on the power play. A swing and a miss by Zibanejad. And that unit goes off after a minute 45 seconds on. Helm was circling, lost it. Breaking in was Strome. He gets it back. That's Gauthier going to the net, getting power play time. Panarin still on. Power play is over.
Yeah, he made a strong move to his backhand to go to the front of the net to Gauthier, but the puck just slid off the end of his stick.
8:40 to go in the third period. Rangers 1 for 4 on the power play in the game. No scoring here in the third. Gauthier tried to make a move on Jack Johnson, who stayed with him. Heedle behind the net. 6-2, Avalanche lead it. Lundqvist, pass taken away by Landeskog. Breaks to the net, and they caught up with him. Lundqvist, good job getting back. As Landeskog almost had a breakaway. Here's Lafreniere moving in. In the middle, Heedle scores! Beautiful setup. Lafreniere and Heedle combined and cut the Avalanche lead to 6-3.
Now, just prior to the goal, Landeskog anticipated where the puck was going. He intercepts it. Lundqvist gets back. So does Keandre Miller. And then Miller quickly moves it up the ice. Moves it up. And then the pass to the slot. And a quick shot by Heedle. And the Rangers make it a 6-3 game. So Miller came back, helped on the defensive side. He'll get an assist. Lafreniere will get one as well. And Heedle with the goal.
Heedle had gone 10 games without a goal. Kemper getting some equipment checked out in front of the Colorado bench. Nice pass from Alexi Lafreniere to set up Philip Heedle. good to see those youngsters come through.
Well, these are, you know, you're a young player, you learn a lot playing against a team like this. And so, you know, so this is a learning experience for Heedle. Play against McKinnon and some of these players. And then this was shorthanded. Helm with this chance. And Huska, beautiful left pad save. As the stick goes one way, he makes the save and then gets a little help from Fox.
Philip Heedle gets the goal, his third of the season. Lafreniere and Miller, the assist at 11:52. It's a 6-3 game with 8:08 to go. And
well, can't fix it in time.
Kempfer's going off.
Still 8:08 to go. Right, get some shots. And
Johansson is going in.
Yeah.
And let's go to Dave Maloney, who's right by Jonas Johansson.
Yeah, a good look here. The youngster was originally drafted by Buffalo, but that Wes McCauley, oftentimes noted as one of the premier officials in the league, he took control. He said, that's enough. Bring out the backup goalie. That was it. Move the game along. And as a result, we have, as an equipment issue, a new goaltender in the net for Colorado. So maybe, Joe, you want to get the pucks to the net here early.
Yeah, yeah. Attack. Get shots there, get some players there, who knows.
Newhook back for it for Colorado. Swings it around the boards. Nemeth able to help keep it in. Reeves. Out goes Huska to play it. Nemeth, Newhook on him. Reeves plays it into the Colorado zone. On the boards, Burakovsky lost it to Reeves, gets a shot on goal.
72, Philip Heedle.
Heedle being announced as the goal scorer.
The assist to number 13, Alexi Lafreniere.
Gauthier. Reeves actually is still on now. He goes off and Gauthier comes on. Huska gloves that, drops it off for Keandre Miller. 6-3 game. Kempfer faced 35 shots, excuse me, 24 shots, made 21 saves. Let's see if he gets the equipment fixed.
He's still back there, right behind the glass, where the Zamboni enters and exits.
Girard tried to play it toward the front, was blocked. Aubé Kubel to Eric Johnson for a shot. They score! There was a screen in front of Huska.
I think Rantanen tipped it, Sam.
Okay.
Yeah, I think, you know, we talked about him and Kreider, you know, before the game, and they got, for big men, they got such great hands. And I think this is one where he just softens up the hands and just gets a deflection. There he is, 96. Now just watch him in front. There he is. Let's see what he does. Yeah, beautiful little deflection. That looks like what we've seen Kreider do so often. Just soften up your hands on your stick. Turn the blade a little bit and he deflects it in, and Darcy Kemper is able to get his equipment back where it's supposed to be, and he goes back in.
7-3, Colorado leading it. They scored 7 in the game against Philadelphia on Monday night.
And now I can see the officials going, come on, let's go. Now he's ready to go.
In the last 5 games, the Avalanche have scored, last 3 games, they've scored 5, 7, and 7.
Yeah, it's a scoring machine is what they are.
7-3, that 7 goals represent the most the Rangers have given up in a game this season. One of those games that got out of hand in the second period. This is the Rangers' 5th set of back-to-back games. They had been 2-1-1 in the second game of the previous 4. .545 to go. Rangers will fly to Buffalo tomorrow. for the Sabres Friday night. The late penalty upcoming on the Avalanche. Rangers get an extra skater on. Zibanejad moves in, plays it toward the net, stopped by Kemper, and Rangers power play coming up. 5:27 to go in this third period. 7-3, Avs lead it. Action pass of the game.
Well, that was the chance first, and then Lafreniere down the wing, waits, and finds Hedl right in the middle and gives him a soft little pass that Hedl could take the shot right off the pass. Good vision, good pass by Lafreniere, and Hedl ends up finishing the play just inside the post. And now here's the play. This is Hunt and MacKinnon that come together, and MacKinnon ends up getting a roughing penalty.
At 14:33, Rangers' fifth power play, and Gerard Gallant giving his fourth line players a chance to play power play. Goodrow, Reeves, Rooney, Lundqvist, and Trouba for this Rangers power play. The Colorado's seventh goal was Rantanen, his second of the game, from Eric Johnson and Obe Kubel at 13:25.
You know, I think it's smart. It's not that he's penalizing his other players. They just have had such a difficult time in this game. He probably figures why should I let them just keep getting frustrated and have negative thoughts about this? You know, just get this thing over with, move on.
Devin Rudy, who's had a couple of good chances shorthanded, just had a good chance on the power play. Kemper made a good save. A pass intended for Helm.
Ryan Reeves is down on the ice at that attempt to clear the zone, which it ended up did, but it hit Ryan Reeves, and he was very slow to get up and slow to make his way to the bench.
Having trouble getting there, kind of gliding, not putting pressure on his left leg. Avalanche clear all the way down. Just under a minute to go on the power play. Fox and Miller come on with Hedl, Lafreniere, and Gauthier. Rangers down 7-3. Colorado scoring seven goals in the game for the fifth time this season. Shot toward the net, saved by Kemper. He was bumped by Hedl. No call on the play. Fox steps up. Hedl to Fox. Gauthier's in front. Here's Fox shooting, deflected away by McDonald. Hedl to Fox. DeAndre Miller. Alexi Lafreniere back to Miller. Here's Fox. Fakes, shoots, blocked in front. Hedl back to Fox. Final seconds of the power play. Fox walks in. Saved by Kemper. Good save. The left shoulder. Power play is over. Rangers 1-for-5 on the power play in the game. 7-3 Colorado leading it with 3:10 to go. Saved by Kemper on a hard shot. DeAndre Miller with his setup that goes off the post. Hedl came very close to scoring again. So the Rangers will see their streaks end. Their overall winning streak will end at 7. Their home ice winning streak will end at 8. Zibanejad got the shot off and went wide. But only the second loss in the last 13 games for the Rangers. That's pretty good number,
I'd say.
And they'll be back in action Friday night at Buffalo. To start a new streak. Kreider with the puck. That's deflected wide. Rangers will be in Denver to play the Avalanche again next week. Next Tuesday night. It'll be a national broadcast on ESPN Plus. Lindgren has to go all the way back to get the puck. Under 2 minutes to go in the game. Rangers' last loss was a 2-1 loss in Toronto on November 18th. It'll be their first loss in the month of December after four straight wins. Eric Johnson. He looks healthy again, Joe.
Yeah, he's gone through a couple of tough years with the injuries, right?
He has.
You mentioned the number one overall pick. That was with St. Louis, and then he got traded to Colorado for Kevin Shattenkirk.
Yes. Who's enjoying himself in Anaheim, I might say.
They're having a good year. So is he.
DeAndre Miller back for it. Rangers were up 2-1 end of the first period. Colorado had 19 shots on goal in that first period, but Adam Huska did well. Nils Lundqvist scored his first NHL goal, and there was hope. But in the second period, the Avalanche just came out and scored 5 goals to break the game open. Each team has scored a goal here in the third. Played across, Lundqvist plays it off the inboard, side of the net. Gauthier trying to get it to Goodrow. Devitt. And the Avalanche, who had a 7-5 win in Philadelphia, put up another 7 spot here, and they wrap up their road trip, their 5-game road trip, going 3-1-1. Final seconds tick off. And that's it. The Avalanche defeat the Rangers 7-3. Good return to the lineup for Darcy Kuemper after missing 5 games. Ryan Reaves testing out that left leg. Still feeling a little bit sore. Let's check out the Infosys stat line, which shows you that Cale Makar skated 3.5 miles tonight. And a good player, good skater, and an outstanding young defenseman who can shoot the puck. Darcy Kuemper comes up with his 9th win, his 10th win of the season, as the Avalanche beat the Rangers 7-3. Rangers winning streaks are over, and they'll have to collect themselves and be back in action Friday night.